Do you have a new initiative to help your employees get more organized, especially as it pertains to understanding the structure of your organization? You know, an employee directory is going to go a long way to help you achieve that goal, and it doesn't have to be as difficult as you might think. In this quick video, I'm going to show you how you can stand up an employee directory using a template in Softr, and we're also going to have the back end of that supported by Airtable. Of course, you don't have to use these tools, but if you follow this tutorial step by step, you can have your own employee directory in a matter of minutes. So, if that's of interest, stick around and let's get into it. Welcome back to the channel. If you're new here, my name is Gareth, and this is Gap Consulting, where we help you to get organized and automated with no code. One of our favorite no code tools is Softr. It is the best tool out there for creating that front end portal. If you're trying to create a web application that people on your team access, that your clients access, whoever, well, you can do that pretty easily without any code using Softr. If you don't already have an account, please use our affiliate link that I will share with you wherever you found this video. You can get set up with a free trial and start using it today. Now, as I mentioned, we're also going to be tying this together with Airtable, but Softr has so many different options. It does not have to use Airtable specifically as the back end. You can also use Smart Suite. You can use Google Sheets. The skies are the limit for you, my friend, but here we're going to be using Airtable. So let's go ahead and jump on in. First thing I see when I log into Softr is my little dashboard, as you see right here, and I'm going to create a brand new application. And we can search just for employee directory, because as I mentioned, Softr already has templates built for this. And as you can see right here, there are two different backends that are supported within this template. I can build my backend in Airtable or Google Sheets just with the push of a few buttons. So here I am, employee directory, and over here I can kind of scroll through and see what this has to offer, etc., etc. But since we're going to be going through it in this video anyway, let's go and click on Use Template. And now we have to select our data source. Where are we going to store this information? I've already authenticated Softr with my Airtable, but if you haven't, you can just go through the on-screen instructions one step at a time right here. Once you're set, just click Continue. And now we're going to be asked to set up our application, because what we need is to create that back-end data schema inside of our Airtable or Google Sheets or whatever different application you use for the back-end. So all I have to do is push one button to get this going, and this is going to then open me up inside of that different tool, in my case Airtable, and I can decide where I'm going to store this information. I'm going to drop mine into a little demo space, and I'm going to add this base. It takes just a moment, but of course we're creating the different tables and the different fields inside of this base. As you can see, now that base exists and it's been named Employee Directory by Softr. And also, we have a lot of documentation here. So the first thing you might be drawn to is that we have this README set up. So this is the employee directory. It talks about visualizing the team hierarchy, etc., etc. We also have the team org chart down here. This is an extension inside of Airtable. You don't have to use it because we're going to get that front-end experience in Softr, whether we're using this or not. Really, what I want to do here is just look at the data schema that's been built. So first and foremost, I have my employee directory. So this has the name of the employee, the location that they're in, a photo, also their title, and the employee type, whether they are a manager or an employee, and then also the employment type, whether they are an intern, full-time, part-time, etc. We have their start date, we have a link to the department. If you're new to relational databases like Airtable, this might seem a little funky, but all this means is that we are linking this over to a record over here in our departments table, which we'll look at in just a moment. We then are able to look up the department name. We also link them to a manager. So this is where we're linking data in this table to itself. So in this case, Pat Everett here is Robbie Pritchett's manager. And so if we find by scrolling down that we see Pat right here, Pat is the CEO, it makes sense that she is then managing the VP of engineering. You get the picture. So this is how the database works, but one of the most important pieces here is going to be this email address. This is how people are going to access their account and how we're going to be able to determine which person is actually logged in. This email address is kind of that unique key that helps us inside of Softr. We're storing all this other information though. Home address, date of birth, bio, emergency contact name, you get the idea. Now we're going to take a look at departments. This is pretty straightforward, just the name of the department. Who is that department head? In a perfect world, I actually want to see a linked relationship here, but that's okay. We do have the employees, and we're rolling up the employee count so that we know how many people are within every department. We have a time off request, so this is going to be a component of this overall web application. Notice that the employee puts in that request. They give a reason. We're bringing in their email address, and then of course we're also looking at the type of time off, whether it's sick leave or vacation, and the dates, the start and end date for that time off. So this is really important. Of course, if you're tracking any kind of employment, time off and sick leave, you need a component like this. Did you know you could build it in no code? Well, that's how simple it is. And then lastly, we have a little bit of an expense tracker over here. So maybe not everybody can actually use this. Very likely that there are certain permissions inside the application that say only certain users have the permissions to submit expenses. But here you see Pat, who we already know is the CEO of our fake data. Well, Pat has been able to submit a couple of expenses. They're blank amounts, of course. Let's actually add some numbers in here. We'll make it 500 and 1500. And so now that we have some data, let's go ahead and flip on back now into Softr and take a look at the next steps. So when we go back, we see that our app has been synced up to that backend database that we just built in Airtable, and we can just go to the application. So this is now the front end that we're going to experience. Everything that we were looking at in Airtable, that's just the backend data. And ultimately, nobody's going to actually access that data directly in the back end. What they're going to see is this front end web application. The first thing we want to draw our eyes to is in the top left corner, we have pages. These are all the different pages in our web application. So we have our home page, we have an employee detail, we have departments, we have the department detail, an org chart, booking time off, submitting expenses, account settings, being able to sign in, and what happens if we forget our password or resetting our password. Now, these last few are really important because in order to actually see organization information, we have to be logged in. We have to be a logged in user, and that is our third little section over here on the left-hand side. So these users, if we go and take a look at them, this is the information that lives in our contacts table. Remember, I told you that that email address was going to matter. Well, here it is. Everybody that's inside of our Airtable, back here on that email address, inside of our employee directory, looking at this field, it's all something at example.com. Well, those are the exact same login users that we have over here in our users table. So each one of these people can have their own unique experience inside of that application. But another part that's really cool here inside of Softr is that we have user groups. So a user group is how we can categorize different people based on their information, and we can give them a different type of interactivity, a different user experience inside of that front-end application. And that's done right here. We have this group called managers. So if we take a look and we edit this, we can see that based on conditions here, employee type is manager. Does this seem familiar at all? If we go back to our data in Airtable again, we have a field over here called employee type, and we have a few different options here. We have employee or manager. So by setting up this condition inside of Softr, we can assign people automatically to this group of managers and therefore give them a completely different experience. So let's take a quick look again at who our managers are. We've got Robbie, we've got Sam, we've got Brooke, Jamie, and of course our CEO, Pat. Everyone else is an employee. If we go back now into Softr and we look at one of these pages, going back to our homepage, well, once that homepage loads, if we were to click into an element here, we might find that certain actions, certain features are conditional. So if I look over here at the actions of this block, and I notice that there's this little branch over here, well, that's because not everyone can see this button. This button is conditionally available for our users. How conditionally, you may ask? Well, if they're logged in users that are in the group of managers, then they're going to see the button that allows me to add a new employee. And this makes sense, right? We're not going to give the same permissions to everyone inside of our employee directory. Not everybody is going to be able to hire somebody. Not everybody is going to be able to approve time off or approve expenses. So as you could imagine, we're going to have conditional logic built in there. And I just wanted to highlight for you that that is already built into this template, but you can make it it as robust as you would like. The whole point of a no-code application like this is that you can go in and make changes to your own needs. Let's suppose that I want to actually see the app in action. I can publish it. So we're going to click up here to publish that app. It is now live. Just like that, we have gone live with our employee directory. And if I were to go back to users, I can use this magic link and impersonate somebody. So maybe I want to be Pat here because I know that Pat is the CEO and I want to see the full permissions. I'll go ahead and copy this link and in a new tab, paste that link in, and I am now being logged in as Pat. Take just a moment for me to get in, and here we are. I know I'm Pat because I up here can see Pat's icon. I can go to my account, and I'm going to see Pat's information. I can change my name. Can't change my email because everything's tied to that. I can update my profile picture right here. I can change my password, etc. Once I'm happy with that, I can go back to my homepage. I can scroll down and take a look at my employee directory. Maybe I want to know a little bit more about Jen, our designer in San Francisco. I can click here. It's going to open up Jen, show me when she started, where she's working, you know, her emergency contact information, who her manager is, etc., etc. So as you can see, this is really powerful stuff. Of course, there's a lot of functionality behind here as well, because I might want to book time off, so I can submit my time off request right here, submit the reason, whether sick leave or vacation, put some text in here and say when I'm going to start this. And just like that, I can put that in to request my time off. Similarly, I can submit expenses and fill out that information as well. Now, what I want to point out again is that all this data lives and is powered on the back end in Airtable. So although I just created that record in the web application, I can go into my employee time off, scroll all the way down to the bottom, and we're going to find that new little piece of information that I just submitted. That was the text I typed in there. It was a sick leave request starting on 12/31, and you can see that it even knew who submitted the request because I was logged in as Pat. This is powerful stuff, and this is the tip of the iceberg with no code. I hope you got a ton of value from this video, but if you have some additional questions, be sure to drop them wherever you found the video, and in the meantime, my friend, keep on building.